And you know the state budget has doubled in recent years, but our people have not benefited. People like our teachers, police officers, school employees, healthcare workers. But I know who have benefited. Lobbyists, special interest groups, PACs, politicians. I'm not taking one penny from a politician, a PAC, a lobbyist, or a special interest group. I am not going to be a puppet on a string. A vote for Randy Bush is a vote for us.
I want to say something about the airstrip. I'm a pilot. And if I could do one more thing in my life that I had as much fun and joy in as learning how to fly airplanes. But I had a business all over the country. And I could get in my plane at daylight, and I could be having lunch in Odessa, Texas, you know. And that night, having supper in Rock Springs, Wyoming, all by myself, you know. It was the coolest thing. So I've had a lot of fun flying. And you need to do a 6,000-foot strip, though, so we can get it. We get the jet in there. A lot of private jets would come here. It's a lot easier to come into a small airport like the one you're planning than it would be to say land in Baton Rouge. And there's a lot of economic development coming here, and will be. And I'd assure you, someone flying in from New York City with a sack full of money to spend here, they just soon land in a private strip like that as to go into the one that here in Baton Rouge. I've landed in Hammond and Baton Rouge and the one south of town. It's been a lot of fun. I've come here today to ask you to vote for me for Secretary of State. The election is real soon now. And I want to tell you why I would ask for your vote is because of my background and my experience in business, in politics, and in public service. I was born and raised in Jena, Louisiana. That's up in central northern part of Louisiana. It's a great little place to be born and raised from. The greatest thing that ever happened in my life, I was 12 years old. I walked down the aisle of the Baptist church in downtown Jena and took the preacher by the hand. I was born again, got baptized right there. And so nothing any better than my life that I remember from Jena. But got out of high school, I was 17. No job, no car. I packed a bag and hitchhiked to Morgan City where I knew some friends. And went to work on a drilling rig offshore as a roustabout. And I wound up spending my whole adult life in the oil and gas industry after that first day. I went home and went back to college, went to school in Monroe, went to school in Natchitoches, and I finished up in engineering in Houston, Texas. I worked in several different oil field jobs as a youngster. And when I was 30 years old, I decided to start my own business. One truck, one driver. The truck was mine, and I was a driver. Some 30-something years later, I sold that business. I had over 200 18-wheelers. I had almost 500 employees. I worked in every oil-producing state in the United States, Mexico and Canada, and I flew my plane to most of those locations also. It was a lot of fun. I lived the American dream in business, and that's one of the things I try to help anyone who wants to be an entrepreneur like what I did. Because if a little redneck from Gina can do it, you or any one of your kids can do it too. And so I'm here to help. By the way, ma'am, when I get to be the Secretary of State, you should count on me to help you with that airport, okay?
Thank you.
And I do. I love to fly, and I think it's a great thing. It's a great part of economic industry. So let me tell you what happened to me when I was about 40 years old. I'm living in Crowley. That's where my main business was. Edwin Edwards is governor. Everybody's a Democrat over there, except a few. And I'm in a coffee shop with some friends griping about politics. I didn't even like politicians. And somebody told me, says, Francis, you're a Republican. You ought to get on that committee. Go straighten out your politicians. I didn't even know we had a committee. Okay, Bob? I ran against a local guy who was on the state central committee, and I beat him, and I got on the committee. And that's where I first met Bob Morgan 30 years ago. Back then, it was Edwin Edwards' last term as governor. Bill Clinton had just been elected president. There weren't many enthusiastic Republicans in Louisiana, I'll tell you right now. We had about 350,000 Republicans at the time. Now we have over a million. At the time, we had one statewide official, Fox McKithen. Today, all the statewides are Republican except for one, and we're going to fix that in just a few weeks. Now, we had 18 state representatives out of 105. 18. Now we got, what, 70?
71.
71. There are 39 state senators in Louisiana. We had six state senators. And Bob can tell you, just like I would, about half of those guys wasn't worth shooting, you know, really. You'd call them a rhino today. We went from 6 to 14 senators that election. From my first year as chairman, we elected Mike Foster as governor, and the revolution began. And I'm so, that was just a wonderful time in my life. But man, you talk about tough. It was tough. We got on the, had a meeting with Governor Foster in his first year, and he called me in the office and said, look, we're going to have a tax increase. I want you to endorse my tax increase as the chairman of the party. And I said, Governor, Republicans don't raise taxes. And so that was the, kind of the end of my friendship with Governor Foster for a while. They cooked up a deal where the legislature would appoint the Republican committee and the Democrat committee instead of the voters. It's unconstitutional. And they wrote that bill up, and Foster was going to sign it. I told him, I said, don't sign that bill. It's unconstitutional. And he just said, get out of here, boy, you know, and he did it. I filed a lawsuit against my Republican governor.
Yes.
That was unconstitutional. We went to the Supreme Court. We won. We turned back to a powerful governor. Now, I love Mike Foster. We wound up being the very best of friends. But in that particular case, you know, we had a run-in. That's one thing, one proof I want to tell you as Secretary of State, I will stick up against the governor. I don't care if Donald Trump comes down here. We're going to prevail, and what you want to do is what the Secretary of State will do. And I promise you that. I'll give you my word of honor on that. So I had that experience for 6 years leading the Republican Party. I spent over 30 years building a $100 million company and leading it all over the nation. And now over the last 7 years, I've served as your public service commissioner. I was elected the same year Donald Trump was elected. I was elected, I ran against a Republican and a Democrat. And I got 54% of the vote in that first election. I ran for 6 years, and I just ran for a new term. During that first term, I served 2 years as vice chairman and 2 years as chairman of the Public Service Commission. Last November, I was reelected to another six-year term. There's a million people in that district, 17 parishes, and I got 60% of the vote. I think that's a proof of the work I did and the confidence that people had in me as a political operative. I will do that same thing as your Secretary of State, and I want to ask you to consider that when you vote, someone who has the resume and the credentials. I think when I look at the other candidates, I'm kind of prejudiced about my resume. I think I'm head and shoulders above those others. I want to ask you as Republicans to remember my dedication to this party and what we've done in our values. We're pro-business, we're pro-life, we're pro-Second Amendment, and we're for the people, leading the people. One of the things that I've been noted for and people have said is, I'm not a top-down manager. You know, the Secretary of State sits at the top. And so he can be seen as kind of lording it over the rest of the folks. I'm a bottom-up leader. If y'all have ever seen a org chart with all the blocks filled in and you got the one at the top, if you turn that org chart over upside down, then all the folks like you and I, we're the ones who are going to prevail. And that's the people that I listen to as Secretary of State. We've had a lot of criticism about our voting process. A lot of things that I don't agree with have been said. That's one of the reasons that I'm running. The clerks of court talked to me about this issue, and they were concerned about the Secretary of State's activity with things like going back to paper ballots. I'll call that World War II vintage, okay? So I got in the race because of that, because of the encouragement of the clerks and the registrars. 3 weeks later, the Secretary of State says, I'm not running for reelection. So that, I don't know if I smoked him out or what happened, but that's the way it is. And now there's five Republicans running for this office, one independent and two Democrats. There will be a runoff. It's going to be scattered out all the votes. You just need to help me get in a runoff. If I get in a runoff, I'm your next Secretary of State. And I believe we're going to get in a runoff. I think with y'all's help. Please remember the time and treasure I put into the Republican Party. Remember my years of experience as a building a business. And remember my 7 years as a public servant in the Public Service Commission.
Hey everybody, I'm Randy Bush, Senate candidate, District number 37. And do you know the state budget has doubled in recent years, but our people have not benefited? People like our teachers, police officers, school employees, healthcare workers, but I know who have benefited. People and businesses from dozens and dozens of other states, lobbyists, special interest groups, PACs, politicians. I'm not taking one penny from a politician, a PAC, a lobbyist, or a special interest group. I am not gonna be a puppet on a string, and no one's gonna own me. When you go vote on October 14th, you think about that. A vote for Randy Bush is a vote for us.